special use that we designed for this, actually, we never even rehearsed with it. We just kind of decided to do it after the rehearsal yesterday. And Greg had to go out and buy a roll of aluminum foil. Play something on the mic, okay? See if we can get, I see if it actually works. Yeah, it's too tight. You should have kept it looser. Anyway, you get to save $2.59 on that aluminum foil. Actually, what I thought he was doing when I first saw that thing, I thought he was trying to keep a meatball sub warm. Before we play this last tune, I'd like to thank Tom Berry for the sound. I listened to Jazz Band 3 under the able direction of Sam Strantz. I thought it sounded great, so thank you, TB. Now, just a little background on this next tune. I get an email from Kyle Marlin, our lead trumpet player, somewhere toward the end of the summer, close to the beginning of school year, saying that he was at some coffee shop in North Liberty, and they were playing this particular piece on the PA system, and he was enamored with it, and he asked me if there's any chance we could maybe try to find it. So, you know, I didn't really listen to it that much. Had I done so, I would have said, you're crazy, because it's very, very hard. And we have no business playing it, but we're going to do it anyway. I think Kyle must be a masochist, then, because he's got the toughest part in the whole band. He'd check out the lead part on this. But anyway, it's written by a very fine Belgian trumpet player arranger. His name is Bert Joris. If you were here for the Bobby Shue concert a few weeks ago, you heard Jazz Band 1 and Jazz Band 2 play a Bert Joris composition. He's a very fine jazz trumpet player and really great band leader and an arranger, obviously. This is called El Circo, which translates to the circus, but it doesn't sound very circus-like to me, so I'm not sure what the title actually refers to, but you can imagine. Well, then I'll sit there if you want. So anyway, we're going to hear from several soloists. Who's first on this? We have Tanner. He's been quiet all night long, except for that beautiful duet with Brian. So we're going to turn Tanner loose on this, and he's actually playing what was supposed to be a solo bandoneon part, which is kind of a small accordion. So he doesn't really sound like that, but he's going to play beautifully nonetheless. And then, who's second? Lexi's going to play some alto on this, and then Josh, tenor, and Brian's going to bring up the rear with the trombone solo. And not last but not least is magnificent, the mesmerizing Marshall Egerton on drums. You think I'm kidding? You watch him. He's mesmerizing. Okay. So anyway, here goes, for better or worse, El Circo. Thank you.
Thank you.